Leaders say if they don't get this money, they might be forced to freeze teachers' salaries, cut back on programs for kids, as well as transportation services.
Russ Newton lives in the Heron Mort neighborhood in downtown Indy, and while his son is just 7 months old, he says he looks forward to when they'll be able to send him to an IPS school.
We need to improve our schools and compensate our educators appropriately.
So he says he's in favor of the school district pursuing referenda to bring in more money.
If we all share that burden, then that will set us up for future success.
Superintendent Lewis Farabee announcing Thursday that the district is evaluating two referenda, one for $736 million over 8 years, going toward operations. The other for $200 million for things like building renovations, tech upgrades, and more security.
While not everyone has children in a school system currently, I think it's extremely important that we consider the long-term impacts and benefits.
So how much will this all cost you? The owner of a home valued at $123,500, the average home price for the district, would pay about $28 a month extra. The owner of a $300,000 home around the average price downtown would pay just over $69 extra a month.
We have to be creative when it comes to funding public education, and some would say it's the new normal.
IPS research released earlier this year pointed to a trend of young professionals moving out of the district once their kids reach school age. The parents we talked to in this neighborhood say they're witnessing a shift.
We've been here in this neighborhood for 10 years, and the dynamics now are that people with school-age children are staying and investing in the area.
Not only attract those young professionals, but keep them right in the core of the city, we need to make sure we're able to offer them high-quality educational options for their children.
Eight other school districts in Marion County have pushed for a referendum, though only six have been successful. Dr. Lewis Farabee says that this is the first time they're doing this in 10 years and need the extra money to be competitive with neighboring districts. In the newsroom tonight, I'm Gabby Gonzalez, CBS 4 News.